A special thank you to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble,
Luxury Pets,
Express Roofing, we've got you covered, Faith Created, Assembly of God Church, ScenicCabin.com, Equipment, Sales and Rentals, give Sean a call, Tatum Enterprises, Richmond Tourism, WKYT.com, Time Warner Cable, Madison County Schools, First Gear, Pro Signs, Berea Online, and Rosenbaum Communications.
Hey everyone, my name's Alex, and I want you to watch MadisonCountySchoolSports.com.
Hello everyone, I'm Madison County School Superintendent Elmer Thomas, and I want to thank you for watching Madison County School Sports Television.
Follow Madison County School Sports Television on Twitter, or like us on Facebook, MCS TV, and of course, watch all of our videos on YouTube.
Welcome to the Coach Mark Thinner Show.
Hi, I'm Samantha Burper with Madison County School Sports Television. We want you to watch the Coach Mark Thinner Show.
We look forward to seeing you on Madison County School Sports Television.
Welcome to the Coach Mark Thinner Show. I'm Samantha Burford, and of course I'm here today with Coach Mark Thinner. He's the head coach of the Madison Central Indians, the new head coach of the Madison Central Indians. Congratulations once again, and thanks for being with us.
Thanks very much for having me. I appreciate the opportunity, and I appreciate just how well represented our program has been through this show.
Yeah. Now, I say new coach. Does it still feel new? You've been practicing a lot now, getting ready. You've had your first scrimmage. Doesn't feel new anymore.
There's a lot of newness still around, I suppose, but it really, as far as being in the school and being around the kids and everything, it definitely is far more comfortable. It was very easy to get back in the groove of being a part of the Madison Central faculty and with so many of our faces on our coaching staff familiar to the previous time when I was here as an assistant, a lot of things. Old things become new again, so that's certainly easy transition.
Well, let's talk about your coaches. Some people know this already, but I think the last time we met, you didn't have everyone lined in place, but now you do.
Right.
Let's talk about them.
Well, we've got Coach Belmar Miller. He is on board as co-defensive coordinator and assistant head coach. And Tim Kirk came back with me from Garrett County. He's a special teams coordinator and co-defensive coordinator.
So a lot of people may not know them.
And associate head coach, right. Yeah, Coach Miller, of course, he's a local guy. He's a retired teacher now and is enjoying coming back and teaching partial day driver's ed at school. I really think he's loving coaching. The passion that he brings and the experience and the knowledge that he brings is just fantastic.
And when you're retired and then you come back, you got to love what you're doing.
Absolutely. Yeah. He loves the kids. He loves being a part of it. He loves, he's such a vital member of the community. And to have a man like that on our staff is very, very special.
Right.
And then Coach Kirk, again, a younger guy. I actually coached him when he was in high school. But, he's a local guy to the county. He's from Berea and went over, was my defense coordinator at Garrett County and agreed to come back. And his greatest asset is his passion for the game and his love for the kids. And he just does a great job of being very, very detailed and teaching the kids in a very detailed, broken down way. Mm-hmm. An excellent teacher and an excellent football coach. I'm lucky to have him.
Mm-hmm.
Ryan Jones is back. He was a quarterback's coach when we were here before. And he's back as offensive coordinator now. Of course, a lot of people know Ryan from his days of playing at Central. Still holds most of the passing records and things like that. And of course, he's, again, he and I have been coaching together for many years now.
Right.
And it's so valuable for the relationship that we've been able to build with that. We kind of know where each other are going. We know what each other's thinking.
Each other's sentences.
In some cases, we do. Yeah, in some cases, yeah. That's for sure. But, he's a very, very talented young coach, a very talented offensive mind. In my opinion, one of the better young play callers around. And having him back at Central at home is a big thing as well. Teddy Taylor is on board with us. And, of course, I don't think there's anybody anywhere that doesn't know Teddy Taylor.
Love Teddy Taylor.
Yeah, you could play this
show.
The
kids love him, too.
Absolutely. You could play this show in Florida. You could play this show a lot of different places, and people would know who Teddy Taylor is. And he's done just a fantastic job.
A lot of people even see him standing out front of the school in the mornings, and you see everybody waving to him as they drive by.
And when you think about Coach Taylor, you just think about a guy who knows how to build relationships and how to bond with kids and people, and again, just a real strong community member, and someone with that wealth of knowledge and that wealth of ability. Being a part of our staff is huge for our young men. And he bonds with kids in a very real way. And they know immediately that they can respect him and they can trust him. And that's why Teddy is Teddy.
He's so successful.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Robbie Riley has come over, part of our staff. He was at Central before and bounced back and forth with the middle school team. He's a staple out at Madison Middle. Everyone out there very familiar with Robbie, and he's a very valuable part of our staff. Mm-hmm. Derek Tipton, former Ferristown head coach, played for was offensive lineman when I was offensive line coach under Coach Raines back in the early 2000s, and Derek is helping us. He's on board as a history teacher at Central, and we've got some other guys who are kind of in paraprofessional roles. We've got Paul Warford back with us, and he's doing a fantastic job helping with our DBs and our running backs. And, of course, a lot of people remember Paul when he played at Central in his days at Kentucky. Keyshawn Simpson, who just freshly graduated off of Western Kentucky and had a great career with Western Kentucky's football team, he's back helping our running backs. Whitney Todd Parsons, a local guy, he helped us over at Garrett County, and he's on board as a paraprofessional. And D.T. Boone, who he's a pharmaceutical rep by trade, but has dedicated a tremendous amount of time to our program in coaching. He played at Ohio and had a very successful career as well. And then Shelby Goldie, who actually I first met when the Madison Central staff was coaching an All-Star game way back in the early 2000s, and I kept up with him through college. He's a Garrett County graduate and helped us out when we were over with our staff over at Garrett County, and he came over in a paraprofessional role. So. We've got a large staff, a lot of guys who have a lot of knowledge and great not only playing experience but teaching experience, and I just feel so blessed to have the staff of men that I have.
And people wonder why it took you so long to get the staff together. Hello, that's a long list.
Well, it is, and and we're trying to be as detailed and as specialized as we can. With good numbers, we need a good number of coaches, and each one of these guys brings a different strength to the table.
Right.
And it really allows us to hopefully get in and teach the kids in a very individual way.
Is your number on the football team, how many players do you have this year?
We're sitting at about 72 on the varsity roster right now, sophomores through seniors.
Okay.
We are down a few from the spring. We actually dressed 90. In the spring game, and some we've lost some along the way. There's been a little bit of attrition, but that's okay. That happens.
Right.
And
still a building process.
Absolutely, part of the building process coming. And quite honestly, we tell the kids all the time, it takes a very special person to play football. It takes a very special person to dedicate themselves to our process and to the things that we're trying to teach and do. And so that to me just. It doesn't say anything negative about the ones who have decided to part ways. And more than anything, it just says how special the young men who are still with us are, and that they're buying into the process and dedicated to the program. And I'm really proud of them for that. And then, not only do we have the 72 on the varsity roster, but we've got almost 50, right at 50 on our freshman team roster.
Wow.
We've got a fully staffed freshman program, four solid coaches, and Steve Roof, who's obviously our head baseball coach, is also our head freshman coach. Steve and I coached together years ago, and I think he's just a fantastic coach, very detailed. Mm-hmm. exactly the type of person that I want running our freshman program because he is so detailed. Mm-hmm. Chris Minner's helping him, and Tony Rose and Joe Huff are all Central guys, and they're helping out. So I feel great about the four men that are leading our freshman program.
Right.
And the fact that we have 50 freshmen, I think it tells a great deal about where the direction our program's going.
That's exactly right, moving in the right direction.
We want to get to the point to where, you know, we're averaging 30 or so players per class, and having 50 on the freshman team is a great start from that. And, you know, keeping an eye on these middle schools and seeing what's coming, I feel like all three schools have fantastic eighth grade teams this year, and the sixth and seventh grade teams behind them are stocked as well. I'm really excited about the direction that our middle school programs are going, and all of our three feeder schools, you know, that if we can get numbers up there and they can continue to make the rise up, all of those things lend themselves to getting our numbers where they need to be.
Right. Well, and even I know as far as my children going to Madison Middle, the site-based councils are changing dress codes, at least at Madison Middle, just so that our students can promote Madison Central football, basketball, and other sports on Fridays. For they're going to allow them to wear Madison Central attire so that they can, you know, get the spirit.
And I think that's so important, and mm-hmm. because, you know, at all three middle schools, you know, that I completely understand the concept that they're in conference together, and really and truly they're going to have to beat one another in order to have a chance to win their conference mm-hmm. championship. But again, that lends itself to why our freshman program is so important, because it's our first opportunity to get those three schools together, and they're all going to come be Indians, and that's what we want, them to come be an Indian. And you know, having those three schools come together, and again with the quality of kids that the middle schools are turning out, the fact that they're buying into our process and that they want to mm-hmm. allow the kids to promote Madison Central, that, you know, it allows them to feel connected and part of our school, which is huge. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the kids that are connected to the schools, data shows the kids that feel connected to their schools are the kids who are being most successful. They're the kids who are successful in the classroom, outside in the extracurricular activities,
exactly.
all the way around. And though that's exactly what we're trying to build, is that mm-hmm. community and camaraderie, and hopefully, you know, we can continue to move that process right on down to the youth leagues, and you know, we may be the top of the pyramid, but those guys are the ones who are feeding us, and they've got to be healthy for us to be
That's
healthy.
Right, especially if this is going to be a long tradition of Madison Absolutely. Central football.
Absolutely, and that's exactly what we hope it to be.
Right. Let's talk about the scrimmage this past weekend. Mm-hmm. Tell us your thoughts on that game against Pulaski County.
Well, I mean, obviously scrimmaging a very, very strong 5A football school in Pulaski. We all know what they did last year in the state championship run that they made in 5A, and,
yes.
and they returned virtually everyone off that team, had a few differences at the line's positions, but other than that, basically the same team. You know, and we really felt that it was important to have a strong opponent early. You know, we want to find out where we're at. We don't want to kid ourselves about where we're at in the process. We want to know exactly where we are, because our schedule week in and week out, there are no breaks. We're going to have 10 straight weeks of very, very strong competition, and we have to prepare against strong competition to be ready for that. So Pulaski was the perfect choice for a scrimmage, and the fact that they were willing to come back up to our place and play on the turf was really good. You know, for those that have seen the scrimmage, you know, Pulaski mm-hmm. pretty much had their way with us up front, in particular, especially in the first quarter. Yeah, first
mm-hmm.
quarter, about halfway through the second quarter. They really asserted themselves on the front line. You know, a couple things showed there. Number one was obviously the strength factor, and the fact that Pulaski obviously has a very, very established weightlifting program. They have a very established strength and conditioning program, something that we're trying to do. Obviously, the change in the staff from and of course, as it turned out to be, multiple changes. Now, you know, no one could have saw that coming, but as it turned out to be, you know, certainly those things have possibly contributed to our kids being behind a little bit in strength. However, you know, we'll talk about this a little bit later, but with the new weight room and in place and weightlifting class being a class that our student athletes can sign up for now, all of those
Makes
things are
going to
be huge. Yeah, and you know, and our kids are so fired up to be a part of it. You know, I mm-hmm. was down there towards the end of the class. Coach Roof's running that class now, and I was down there towards the end of the class the other day, and just seeing our kids and the passion that they have and how hard they're working. And, you know, I made the comment to our guys, you know, we have a weightlifting program now. We don't just have guys that are coming and showing up every now and then to lift weights. We have an established, expected weightlifting program. We're going to be very intentional with that program, very regimented with that program, and it'll help things tremendously. But again, getting back to the scrimmage, I think that the strength factor up front was obvious right away up front. Again, Pulaski, very good football team. Once we kind of calmed down and got ourselves a
little focused. Do you think they were nervous?
Focused, I do. No question. I think they were nervous, wanting to show us what they could do. I think they were nervous, you know, just getting back on the field, the butterflies. It was a real odd night, too. You know, we had planned on starting the scrimmage at 6, and we already knew.
Their bus broke down.
Yeah, we already knew that we were going to push it back to 6:30 because they couldn't get a bus. And then, lo and behold, he calls me. We're literally getting ready to take kids out on the field to start pregame. And I get a message from Coach Hines that their bus had broken down in Mount Vernon, which had to be a rattling experience for their kids as well. But, you know, our kids were kind of all amped up and geared up, ready to go out for pregame, and then we had to stop and regroup. And and so we ultimately ended up getting on the field about 7:30, which really and truly was about an hour and a half past when we kind of planned on getting out there. And that took its toll. And then, of course, the real bizarre change events there towards the middle to the end when the referees ran us off the field because they saw lightning. And then, you know, we didn't really have any kind of major issue that came out of that. But because they had
changed
heard the thunder.
Pace of the, of the game.
Yeah, it really did.
But you have to be excited about the third quarter.
Absolutely. You know, again, we made a play. Coots made a play down the seam in about halfway through the second quarter, somewhere along the way. As coaches, we're kind of treating it as a practice. Now, obviously, it's a practice against someone else, but, you know, we're kind of in that focused practice mindset as well. And somewhere along the way, we called a timeout, and I called the kids over and just to kind of give them a chance to breathe. Just to kind of give them a chance to kind of breathe and regroup and understand, you know, things are okay. Mm-hmm. Let's hit the reset button and let's go out and kind of regroup here. And you know, someone step up and make a play. And Coot stepped up and made a play on a ball, and a good throw, and got us down the seam. And that kind of broke the ice a little bit for us, and we started moving the ball a little bit. And in the third quarter, again, we did some good things. And of course, you know, Pulaski was subbing. There's no question. You know, they had started subbing some players in, and obviously, you know, we at that point we had started making a few subs too, but we did get the ball moving and get some good movement in the third quarter. Offense started clicking a little bit, had some stops, things were progressing pretty nicely there, and then about that time was when we had the delay. So, all in all, great work against a great football team. Anytime you can get really good work against a very sound championship caliber football team, and no question, anybody, Pulaski is definitely a championship caliber football team. Coach Hines has done a great job for years, but now with the talent there as well as their program being at a high point, you know, they're certainly a championship caliber football team. Mm-hmm. So anytime you get work like that, it's a great thing for a program, and our kids have learned from it. We've had an abundance of film to teach off of, and we've done that over the course of the weekend, and now all sights are on Murray.
Before we talk about Murray, let's talk exciting news. Let's move it into the weight room.
Okay.
How happy you must be to have this new, a very expensive weight room. I mean, parents are talking, they're thrilled.
Well, I mean, we're elated, obviously, as a football program because we'll directly benefit from it, but you know, the whole school, all of athletics will benefit from it.
And that's
the best thing about it. You know, you would not have a science class without a science lab,
right?
And you would not have a band without an auditorium and instruments, and you know, you can't have an advanced PE weightlifting course without the proper equipment, and that was one of the things that Mr. Munz and Mr. Fritz and myself spoke about, honestly, right from the get-go. Mm-hmm. And, you know, quite frankly, we have a wonderful weight room. We have a weight room that I think many small colleges would be tickled to death to have. And we did it on a very good budget. We did not spend nearly the amount on that weight room that could have been spent.
Right.
But we have You know, we have 14 power racks. We have an abundance of plate-loaded machines. We have dumbbells and medicine balls that we had never had before. You know, when I went in, I knew exactly what I was going into when I went into Madison Central,
even
that first night when Mr. Muntz and Mr. Fritz were showing me around, you know, because all of that equipment was the exact same equipment when I had been here before.
Right.
And you know, right down to the flooring and virtually everything was the exact same. You know, and we can just be so much more streamlined and so much more organized now. The power racks with each station being fully equipped is so important, because now, instead of kids running around the weight room trying to find the weights that they need to do the weight that they need to put on the bar, it's right there for them.
And organized.
It's organized. And our goal, you know, we take great pride in our facility. You know, with the facility that we're blessed to have, both indoors and out, we take great pride in our facility, and we want to keep it as nice as we possibly can. I think all of the sports are taking great pride in the facility and putting it to good use already. While I have a huge anticipation for this season coming up, I'm also looking forward to an off season, to get a full off season in that weight room and see just how much progress we can make.
Well, and I spoke with Mr. Muntz, Principal Muntz. He gives you all the credit for getting this weight room accomplished. He's very excited and says you did it.
Well, I did.
It takes a team.
I did it with a lot of help. Let's put it that way. We knew the right people to contact, and we had the right support in place. And you know, that's what good administration does, is they say, we need to get this done. Let's help you get this done.
Right.
And then when we show them how to get it done, we get it done. And believe me, it took, you know, from Mr. Thomas and Mr. Neely to Mr. Muntz and Mr. Fritz, and all of us were pulling together as hard as we could pull to get it done. But thankfully, we got it done, and we have something that the school can be proud of for years to come.
Right.
And the most important thing is that as we go forward, we continue to upkeep it properly, take care of it properly, and make sure we maintain things so that, you know, 10, 15 years from now, that it's still in as good shape and we have the improvements again. You know, it's important. It's important to me personally. It's important to me not only as a football coach, it's important to me as a father, because my sons are going to be coming through this program soon.
And you want to teach these young men, this is important. This stuff has to be here for a long time. Let's maintain it and keep it.
That's exactly right. If it's worth having, it's worth taking care of. My father taught me that a long time ago. If it's worth doing, it's worth doing right. And if it's worth having, it's worth taking care of.
Right.
So that's a message that we want our players to know. And we want to make sure that we have everything in place to make it successful right on down the road. We, you know, again, we talk about the middle schools. We talk about the youth leagues. These kids are going to be here before you know it. It baffles me now, especially the older I get and the older my kids get, how fast time is flying. It will only be a few short years until my son, who's going into sixth grade at Madison Middle now, will be coming to high school and beyond. And it's just going way too fast.
But we're
just fighting, trying to keep up.
Right. Coach, we're going to take a quick break so that we can talk about our sponsors, show them, because without them, we wouldn't be here being able to do this coach's show. Do want to thank Jack Burford Chevrolet. They're our official coach's sponsor. They give us this whole layout and let us take over their facility for a good hour, right? Mm-hmm. So maybe they'll let us drive a few cars. I don't know.
Looking forward to that.
Yes, me too. There's a Corvette out there we got to take. All right, we'll be right back. And when we come back, we'll talk about the Coach Roy kickball. All right, we'll be right back right after this.
A special thank you to our great sponsors. Jack Burford Chevrolet, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble,
Luxury Pets,
Express Roofing, we've got you covered, Faith Created Assembly of God Church, ScenicCabin.com, Equipment Sales and Rentals, give Sean a call, Tatum Enterprises, Richmond Tourism, WKYT.com, Time Warner Cable, Madison County Schools, First Gear, Pro Signs, Berea Online, and Rosenbaum Communications.
Hi, I'm Samantha Burper with Madison County School Sports Television. We want you to watch the Coach Mark Center Show.
We look forward to seeing you on Madison County School Sports Television.
Okay, right there.
We'll be right back.
the Coach Mark Center Show. I'm Samantha Burford here at Jack Burford Chevrolet. They're our official coach's sponsor. Coach, we got a big Saturday night coming up.
We do.
The Roy Kidd Bowl.
Yes.
Two games going on. We'll just briefly mention the first game is Harlan County versus Bryan Station. That one's at 5:30. Everybody's welcome to come out and see that.
Should be a great game. Two very, very strong teams. Bryan Station, I know for a fact that they're looking forward to a big year. They bring everybody back. They're looking for a quarterback, but they bring everybody back. And Harlan County, of course, always tough. And, you know, two contrasting styles a little bit. You got the spread, wide open passing attack, Bryan Station, power football from Harlan County.
Yes.
Should be a good one.
Should be good. You won't get to watch it, though.
Yeah, I'll be a little busy.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. All right, and then let's talk about your game. I mean, Murray, what are your thoughts on them?
Well, outstanding football team, outstanding 2A team. Very, very impressed with what we've seen on film from them. You know, if you want to see something unique, come out and watch our game against Murray. Murray's running basically a single wing style offense. They call it shotgun double wing, but you know, they're packed in. If local folks have seen Estill County play, Estill County a couple years back was running a real tight double wing formation where the linemen are foot to foot, and they've got the fullback and the tail all tucked up underneath there. Well, basically it's that formation with the supreme athlete at quarterback, the number one, I believe his name's Hornbuckle. He's just an outstanding athlete, and you can tell he really relishes his role in that offense as the quarterback, kind of the trigger man. He does it and does it well. He's got the ability to hurt you with the outside run, while he also throws very, very well on the run, throws the deep ball pretty well, and just a really unique style of offense, an old-time offense, old-school offense for sure, especially the way they run it, but they also have the ability to flood it and throw it deep as well. So, you know, our defense is going to have our hands full. We're going to have to play assignment football. We're going to have to play very disciplined football. And we're going to have to show that we're willing to get down low and play football and play tough, hard-nosed, physical football against these guys, especially from a defensive perspective, looking at their offense. In order to stop that offense, they force you to get physical with them. And so we're really going to have to do that. And they have, I mentioned their quarterback. He's an outstanding athlete. They have another young man, number five, who is an outstanding tight end, defensive end. Really, really good football player, about 6'5", 240. He looks the part in all means.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they have several good football players, a good football team, a team under new coaching staff as well. So they're making the adjustment to a new coaching staff as well, but it looks like they have made that transition very well.
Because so it's going to be a good matchup.
I think so. I think it'd be a great matchup. You know, they are a 2A school, but they're also a 2A school that's been in the state finals or state semifinals several of the last few years. They know how to be successful.
Yeah.
Coach Steve Duncan was there before. He's moved on to Logan County, but you know, the kids have had a great deal of success under Coach Duncan. And they know how to work. They know how to be successful. They've got plenty of good athletes. 2A school with about 70 on the roster that they're bringing up here, according to the numbers that I saw from the coach the other day. So obviously really strong numbers. And I think it'll be a very good opening test for our football team.
Now, a lot of people are really excited. I believe it's halftime of the Central Murray game.
That's right.
So your game starts at 8 p.m.
Yep.
Like we said, the first game's at 5:30. So really exciting news. During the presentation at halftime, I want to make sure I get the year right. 1964, Madison High School. Wasn't Madison Central back then. It's Madison High School. They were the state runners-up in football.
Yep, Madison High, the 50-year anniversary of the Madison High team. Of course, Madison Central was in its infancy at that time.
Right.
I believe 63 was the very first football team that Madison Central fielded. And the 64 Madison High football team. A lot of history around that team, you know, so many local guys who have gone on and been very successful community members were part of that football team. They're all getting together on Friday night for a reunion dinner, and this is just something, a real special thing. And it's been so neat because, you know, we started kind of toying with the idea, and we made some contact through John Lovell, helped us contact some folks. Of course, Coach Miller helped us contact some folks with his brother being a part of the team, and Jimmy Dale Williams and some others got together, and you know, it's a core group of about six guys off that team that really just taken off and ran with this thing. So they've got a real nice dinner planned on Friday night at 6 o'clock over at Hangers, that they're going to have a nice reunion dinner and get together and do some things. And then we hope to, you know, to have a real nice evening for them when we honor them on the field there at halftime, during the halftime of our game
right,
two.
Right.
And I look forward to that. And I hope it's a very special night for them, but I also hope that it's a special night for folks in the community that remember
right.
the team. And it's a way to show our young men that you know, you can be very successful at a very, very high level here, right here in Richmond with football. And
right.
those guys have done it. And it's something that we hope to aspire to as well. Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we're going to be there. We'll be filming your game. And Madison County School Sports Television, we're going to be filming the halftime show. So
great.
We're looking forward to, you know, promoting them as well and making sure they get represented just as well.
Yeah, and I know that they're going to appreciate that. And again, our main goal, I've told those guys several times, you know, our main goal is we want it to be a very special weekend for them. We want to honor them. And their accomplishments, and be a chance for them to get together. And again, not only hopefully they'll benefit from it, but I know we're going to benefit
right.
from it, just from the kids being able to see those men and how successful they've been, and their account of how football played a part in their lives, and they were successful years later because what they learned is high school football players, and that's
right.
what we're trying to sell.
Exactly. Let's talk about, a lot of people are really interested, and the good thing is you can make choices. Do you know who your starting lineup's going to be? More importantly, a lot of people want to know which quarterback you're going with.
Yeah, that seems to be the question that pops
it
up.
It is.
I was walking.
People are asking me. I'm like, I haven't. Yeah. I don't know. I won't know until tonight.
Walking off the youth league field with my son the other day, I had that question come
yep.
up, and you know, it's bizarre how many times that question's come up. And
wouldn't
and
it nice to know you have choices?
That's right. And you know, we may keep that one in our pocket a little
all
bit
right.
longer. But
secret. You got to show up to find out.
That's right. But the truth of the matter is we have two quarterbacks who are outstanding. And they complement each other very, very well. You know, one's strength may be something the other one is a little bit not, I don't want to use the term weaker on, but I'm just saying one of them's strength complements the other one's strength very well.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Cameron's a little bit more mobile. Zach's a little bit more of a typical pocket passer. Both of them are extremely smart young men. Both of them are extremely talented leaders. Both of them are winners. And that's what I love about them both. And they complement each other well. And they complement our football team well. So, you know, it may be a situation where we ride the hot hand. It may be a situation where we game plan that week and we think, you know, a particular style mm-hmm. is the way we need to go, which again, their talents fit what we're trying to do offensively so well, because what we want to do is put our kids in the best position to make plays. And we, although we do try to keep it fairly simple, our offensive system in particular, I think is predicated far more on doing it the right way and keeping it simple, and we're going to do what we do. But it also is predicated on putting those kids in the right position to make plays. So we have items in our offense that can be successful and help each accentuate each one of their strengths.
Mm-hmm. Do you have the rest of the lineup organized, ready to go?
Pretty close. There may be some mixing up on the offensive line a little bit. We may do a little bit more substituting up front, trying to keep some guys fresh.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we just feel like that we've got a stable of kids that can make plays. And the important point now is that those kids understand and do step up and make plays. You know, we've told, particularly the running back's such a deep position with Johan Williams and Corion Cryer and Jalen Powell and Jonathan Ty and Jabari Hughley. You know, five deep at the running back spot. Jared Grant, Brandon Northern, Billy Thompson, other guys doing a real good job at our H-back, kind of our power back position. And our wide receiver core is just crazy deep.
Mm-hmm.
At our slot, we've got Blake Gross, we've got Cody Kidd. You know, we've several guys that are in the mix there. With the wide receiver position, obviously we've got John Williams, we've got Nathan Coots, we've got Keenan Miller, Lawrence Lee, Ryan Burberry, Trevor Bean. You know, and I'm forgetting guys right now
yeah.
because we're about six or seven deep out wide. And so, you know, the big thing is we've told those guys, you know, you're not going to see the ball more than likely and obviously the ebb and flow of the game can dictate some things. And maybe if somebody's got a hot hand, maybe they see it a little bit more. But more than likely, you're not going to see someone with our offense get the ball 15, 20 times a game.
Right.
So when they do see it, they've got to do something with it.
Right.
And when we see them in practice make plays, then they're going to get more opportunity to make plays. When we see them in games make plays, then they're going to get more opportunity to make plays.
Right.
So it kind of feeds itself. And those who thrive in that situation will kind of separate themselves, and those who need a little bit more time before they fully develop into that role, then they'll get their more time. I feel like we've got tons of kids that can make plays. I really do. And certainly we're at a point now where we need to start thinning that down and being a little bit more focused, and by all means we are, but at the same time, you know.
But it's the beginning of the season.
That's right. The more kids.
That's expected.
That's right. The more kids that are making plays, the better.
That's right.
And, you know, we're not going to be a one-horse team. So the more kids that are making plays, the better. It will help us to be diverse. It will help us to be as versatile as we can possibly be on the offensive side of the ball, and hopefully make us awfully difficult to scout.
Well, we want to make sure everybody knows. Come out to the Roy Kidd Bowl Saturday night, 8 o'clock. I know Coach Kidd will be excited to get to see his grandson play. He's healthy. Broke 2 collarbones last year at different times, correct? So didn't get to play too much, but you know Coach Kidd's got to be excited.
Oh, I would think so, and hopefully he understands. You know, that's one thing. I hope that he understands we're trying to recognize him and his accomplishments, and certainly he's a major part of the community, and not only the football community, but the community as a whole. He came by practice today.
Oh, he did.
And watched some from the stands, and you know, I can see that's pretty special.
Yes.
You know, it's pretty special. This week has been very special for me. You know, with my son, my oldest son at Madison Middle, getting his first middle school action in, and my younger son, he's catching on with youth league, and then my old high school coach, Glenn Green, comes out and visits practice a couple days ago, and then Coach Kidd coming out and visiting practice today. It's been a good week, and most importantly, let's top it off with a win on Saturday night to make it a really good week. It just so excited. It's a really good thing.
So your thoughts have to be, actually my thoughts have to be, are you setting any new traditions that you want to do with the student athletes, the men, every week?
Well,
you think, let's start this.
We do. We've got some things like that. We're probably hold those a little close to the vest, honestly. We try to keep some things pretty, you know. The one thing that's very special to me is our pregame meal routine and how we go through the game day process itself. Those who know me well know that the pregame meal situation is something that's very exciting for me.
Turning my phone on.
I got you.
It's
got
on silent, but it's still buzzing. Keep going.
But the pregame meal and the process that we go through with the pregame meal on game day, the kids all gathering together. I just think there's something special about it. You're sitting down eating together, you kind of form bonds and all that, and then we move straight on into team meetings, and straight on in from the team meetings to getting dressed and ready for the game, mm-hmm. and the next thing you know, you're out there. So, you know, that whole process of the pregame,
right.
to me,
and keep
is,
them relaxed,
is really special.
Keep them focused, mm-hmm. and realize what they're there for.
Exactly.
It's game night.
Exactly. I mean, you got to be focused, and all of that is all part of the focus process and getting them on the same page. I like that. I kind of value those type of things, and you know, like the kids we're going to have, the kids are pretty excited about getting to wear their game jerseys to school. That's something that I never even thought about, but the kids are pretty excited about simply getting to wear their game jerseys to school on Friday. So hopefully we don't have any accidents in the art room or the science room, and,
no
and things
explosions
like that.
In chemistry lab.
Yeah, we certainly don't want anything like that. But you know, it's special.
Right.
You know, it's special to get up and. You get that jersey on Thursday night, and you go home, heck, I remember, early on getting mine and sleeping with it the night before, and then you get up the next morning, and you put that jersey on, you wear it to school,
right.
You know, there's just something very special about getting the opportunity to wear that jersey on a Friday or on a game day to school, and everybody knowing you're a football player. There's also a great deal of responsibility that goes along with that, and mm-hmm. we want our young men to understand that side of things as well, because whether you've got the jersey on or not, people know you're a Madison Central football player, and there's a high standard, and they're watching. Mm-hmm. And we want to make sure that people are watching know that I want everybody to know just how great our young men are. And we have fantastic young men, and it's important that they represent themselves and their families and our program in the right way, especially when they're wearing a jersey.
Right. Coach, anything else before we let you go because we know you're busy. It's a big week.
It is. Well, I mean, I greatly appreciate the opportunity to come on and promote our program. Anything that we can do to promote our program is very important to us, and thank you for the opportunity. We really want to see folks come out for the Roy Kidd Bowl. This bowl is our major fundraiser for the football program for the year. So obviously, you know, we have a lot riding on that, on this bowl right. game for a lot of reasons. Hopefully the weather will cooperate. I think that'll be a big thing today. Today wasn't a good weather cooperation day, but
no,
hopefully
you've struggled
Saturday
with weather,
will be.
Lightning.
Yeah. Hopefully Saturday will be, and you know, again, just what I think will be two very, very good football games, and a lot of reason for folks to come out. Hopefully the excitement will be high, and more than anything, just get behind these young men. These young men have worked so hard, mm-hmm. and they need to know that the community's behind them, and hopefully we can represent on that football field and come off with a opening win.
A big W.
That's right.
It'd be a great way to start out the regular season,
yeah.
wouldn't it?
They're all big. Yeah,
that's right.
All W's are big W's.
That's
so, yeah,
right.
Yeah, we'll take every one we can get.
That's right. Coach, thank you again. Thank you. We really appreciate it because we know your time is very valuable during football season, and we look forward to doing this next week.
Absolutely, yeah.
All right.
Hopefully coming back with a W and getting ready for Woodford County.
That's right. That's right. All right, thanks for watching. And Samantha Burford, of course, here with Mark Finners. We thank you again, and thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week.
A special thank you to our great sponsors, Jack Burford Chevrolet, State Farm Insurance, Jerry Goble,
Luxury Pets,
Express Roofing, we've got you covered, Faith Created Assembly of God Church, ScenicCabin.com, Equipment Sales and Rentals, give Sean a call, Tatum Enterprises, Richmond Tourism, WKYT.com, Time Warner Cable, Madison County Schools, First Gear, Pro Signs, Berea Online, and Rosenbaum Communications.
Hey everyone, my name's Alex, and I want you to watch MadisonCountySchoolSports.com.
Hello everyone, I'm Madison County School Superintendent Elmer Thomas, and I want to thank you for watching Madison County School Sports Television.
Follow Madison County School Sports Television on Twitter or like us on Facebook, MCS TV. And of course, watch all of our videos on YouTube.
Hey everyone, my name's Alex, and I want you to watch MadisonCountySchoolSports.com.